and Renew from the University of Louisiana, Lafayette. My name is Shaylin Woods, and I am the Director of Archivist of the Ernest J. Dane Center, and I'm an Associate Professor in the Edith Garland Beasley Library. In addition to all of that, I am also very excited to be the Master of Ceremonies today as we celebrate this year's Black Heritage Stamp honoring Dr. Ernest J. Dane.
But few contemporary authors have been bestowed the honor of being forever memorialized with a U.S. postage stamp bearing their image. And even fewer are African. And even fewer African American authors have had distinction. Rarely does one get to stand in the shadows of such a towering figure of American history and literature. So it is with much humility and a great sense of honor and privilege that I share some reflections on the life and legacy of Dr. Ernest.
Did not get lost in the mail. I'm pleased that all of you are here. In early 1981, Ernest Gaines received a telegram, not a letter, but a telegram, from the then president of the university, asking him to join the faculty as an English professor and writer in residence. It was Super Bowl Sunday. That day, the Raiders beat the Eagles 27-10, but in luring Ernie Gaines to return to his native Louisiana, the university scored the greatest touchdown of all. In 1981, when Ernie received that telegram, he had written, among others, Catherine Cormier of Love and Dust, Bloodline, and the autobiography of Miss Jane Pittman, among others. One of those titles had already become a TV movie.
Again, I'd say thank you, Dr. Savoy, for welcoming us here today. And thank you to the University of Louisiana Lafayette for hosting this wonderful event. And again, I'm very lucky to be representing the Postal Service here. And we have 650,000 employees that work 7 days a week to ensure that we deliver the mail to 131 million addresses. And I don't think, not me, but I don't think our Postal Service workers get thanked enough. They're in the back. Thank you to everyone here. Unlike many of you here today, I was not privileged to know Ernest Gaines personally. But like millions of people, I have been fortunate to come to know him through his work. And as gifted a storyteller as he was, I find Gaines' own personal story no less compelling. There's a post office in the town of Jeru, and as you may know, Congress is largely Congress is largely responsible for the naming of post offices. So if we have any members of Congress here today, or you all feel like calling them, okay, let's just say that I don't think the Postal Service would object, and I know I wouldn't, I'm all for this, that we name it the Ernest J. Gaines Post Office, and it has a great ring on it. Today and honoring the remarkable legacy of this amazing man.
graduate student here at UL Lafayette in 2003, fall of 2003. When I entered the English department office, he was standing near the mailboxes over there in Griffin Hall, speaking to another professor. I didn't look directly at him, just like you don't look at the sun directly. But I was immediately aware of him being nearby. Both the brightness of his personality and the gravity of his presence were akin to the effect that the sun has on the planets in our solar system. At least that was his effect on me.
She is poet laureate, as I said before, since 2021, and we are fortunate enough to have her here with us today. Please welcome my friend, Ernest.
Let me tell you.